behalf of the faculty, I have the honor of introducing Jonathan Grossman. I'm sorry. There is a metaphysical insight in Jonathan Grossman's work. I mean, not only in the design of being there in the German sense of the word, being there of the actual effects of conception or pre-organization or metaphysical production of most picturesque or, as a matter of fact, a conviction or ideological construct, somatization, relations with spectators, not only in the hat appropriational side of the work or stigmatization coming from cultural feedbacks. This is really important for our student in relation to the 80s. But this feedback, totally well understood, fact and fiction, terrains of endorsement and strategic clarity. Subjectivation without a subject, time and iconographical meltdown of classical canons or categorization, vis-a-vis a mythopoetical dimension. But nobody's better to talk about his work than Mr. Grossmaler.
Thank you, thank you. Oh, that was gorgeous. That was very beautiful. That was really beautiful. Thank you, everybody. Fabian Marcaccio, everybody. Thank you very much. Thank you. Hey, listen. Sorry about that little outbreak in the studio earlier. I buy yourself something nice with that, okay? I didn't mean bad painting in a bad way, you know? You understand. Well, everybody, I am Jonathan Grossmalerman. This is my show. you probably know my work, but why don't we take a little gander at it? But first of all, how about some lights? Woo! Lights! Woo! Woo! Who's your papa? Who's your mama? You're a pony. It's your birthday. Woo! 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 Slide! This is that. Yeah. Try a little hot with the I'm not. That's a rhyming, I think. Come on, try a little. Fuck the slides! Fuck them! Fuck the slides! Jesus. Okay, I don't need you. You know my work. You know my work. I'm Jonathan Grossmalerman. Well, let me start over here, because I'm a little flustered now. Well, first I'd like to begin with how wonderful it is to be here in the world-famous Mohegan fresco barn. It's so wonderful that there's a place that one can honor our from long dead, a mausoleum, if you will, where one can contemplate a medium that no one has used for decades, it's not centuries.
We are practicing fresco here. It's not a dead medium. Sorry.
Jesus Christ, people! You mean to... Sorry, but I see fresco kind of like I see Tibetan monks, you know? It's not even the pretty little bells and the cute little orange costumes, but we live in a post-industrial age, people, and these little guys are making sand paintings, you know? Are you surprised and fu? Just be happy we got them on video, because we can see what they did and stuff. I mean, come on, you know? Well, back to the subject at hand. I'm not going to lead you through step-by-step career, I'm not going to lead you step-by-step through my career as a painter. Not because I don't think it's important and fascinating, but because, well, last week's people did it so well. I figured it'd be easier to make a bunch of copies and pass them out. So I, Dick. I've decided that it would be easier to make a bunch of copies and pass them out. If I could just find my assistant, Timmy. Jesus, Timmy! Has anyone seen Timmy? Who's, Jesus, has anyone seen Timmy? This is a kid, the kid I came up with, Timmy. Timmy, Jesus Christ, Timmy, where are you? Have you seen, who's seen Teddy, the kid I came up here with? He's a fucking menace, that kid. He was supposed to wake me up this morning, which is why I was so late to saw those studio visits. Sorry about that. I'm going to give the kid a talkie to, you know? So, honey, could you pass those around? Could you pass those around, honey? Thank you, baby. Thank you so much. Thank you. Instead, anyway, I decided to give you kids some really healthy advice for your trip through the fabulous art world. Well, fabulous for some of you, but I guess the advice won't do the rest of you any harm. First is get yourself a lawyer. I can't stress this enough, people. For to quote Rabelais, an artist in his studio is worth 2 eggs, but an artist outside his studio is worth at least 30 lawsuits. I was still trying to get yourself a lawyer, someone you feel comfortable with, someone you're not embarrassed to call at 7 a.m. concerned and nervous and ask stupid questions like, so let me get this straight. After everything I've explained to you, it's still considered rape? You know, you position yourself and head off problems at the pass. You know what I'm saying? Save yourselves a lot of trouble. Well, really, speaking